Hi everyone, welcome to our It's a Small World segment of our virtual classroom. It's a Small World is a segment of our lessons dedicated to learning about our cultural backgrounds and the backgrounds of others. Today we will learn about different nationalities, cultures, and customs. As a result, we will become more globally aware of the world around us and be able to share this information with our family and friends. I thought we should start our first lesson with something fun, something you're familiar with, but kind of in a different way. Have you ever wondered what some of your favorite Disney theme songs would sound like in another language? Today's lesson is the Disney-inspired theme from Aladdin in Italian. Let's join Angie, Anna, and Ashley as we take a peek into this whole new world. Pay attention to the lyrics. While they are similar to the English version, they have their own original interpretation.
Ora vieni con me verso un mondo d'incanto, principessa, è tanto che il tuo cuore aspetta un sì. Quello che scoprirai è davvero importante, il tappeto volante ti accompagna proprio lì. Il mondo è tuo, con quelle stelle puoi giocare, non ti diranno no o non si può, è un mondo tuo per sempre.
Il mondo è mio, ti sa sorprendere se vuoi. Se salgo fin lassù e guardo in giù, che sensazione dolce nasce in
C'è
noi.
Una sensazione dolce in
ogni
noi.
Cosa che ho, anche quella più bella.
Hi, Marian Center family and friends. I'm in the art room with Shanice. We will be doing butterfly art. My materials I will be working with will be scissors, pencil, glue, and construction paper. That's my material that I will be doing my butterfly art with. First, Shanice is going to draw a circle. And after she draws a circle, she will be drawing a line. Hold it straight, Shanice. We need a straight circle. And afterward, Shanice is going to be cutting out the circle. scissors. Cut off your circle, Shanice. Pick it up and cut out that circle. Cut out your circle, Shanice. And after Shanice cut out the circle, she's gonna start her butterfly. Shanice, you're gonna turn the circle this way, inside out. Inside out. Then we're gonna get this, that white paper. And you're gonna be gluing the white paper, Shanice. Shanice, you're gonna glue part of the white paper at both ends. Glue from here to there, from here to there. Glue everything. Glue come down some more. Let me help Shanice for a little bit. Sometimes guys, they do need a helping hand. And afterward, Shanice, you're gonna put one of the butterfly here. Put the other one at the next part. You have to even it up. Then you're gonna fold this over. Fold it all the way up. Fold it over. Fold it down. Hold it down, Shanice. You gotta hold it like this. Turn it around. Then you're gonna cut off this part right there. You're gonna cut off right here. Good job. And after you cut off right there, Shanice, then we're gonna get these little round things right here gonna be on the butterfly. Gotta put the glue on them. Gonna put the glue on these. Put the glue on those, the black ones. Don't use a lot of glue. Don't use a lot of glue. Just small amount of glue. Hold it. Small amount of glue. You're gonna put it right here. One. Next one,
right here,
right there, yes. Then you're gonna glue these other two. Put some more glue on it, Chase. You want it to have glue. Then you're gonna put that right here. Mm-hmm. Other one. Okay. Okay, guys. We finished with our butterfly art. Shanice, would you like to show it to them, your friends? That's what our butterfly art look like. You guys at home can do the same thing. You guys at home can get your material. construction paper, glue, pencils, scissors, and do any kind of art that you guys enjoy doing. I just want to let you guys know that we miss you, we love you, be safe, continue your social distance, continue to wear your mask wherever you go, and also the most important thing is your hand washing. Keep washing your hands whenever, every little chance you get, we have to do our hand washing. We miss you. We love you. Goodbye.
Bye.
Hi, Marian Center family and friends. We are in the art room. Some of you guys love doing art, and some of you guys are out there. You guys out there, you guys, I hope you guys are doing fine. I hope you guys are doing your social distance, wearing your face shield or your mask, and also doing your hand washing. This room is some of you guys' favorite room. Some of you guys love doing hearts. My hearts today is pineapple art, and the materials I will be working with will be red paint, glue. Leslie, can you show them the glue, please? The glue right here. Can you lift it up? Leslie, can you show them the brush? Brush, Leslie, right here. Shanice, bubble wrap. Shanice, scissors. And also we have construction paper. There we go. And we're going to be start doing our pineapple heart with the bubble wrap. And Shanice will be painting the pineapple heart with the color red paint. Go ahead, Shanice. This side. Heart is a beautiful work to do, guys. Some of you guys are so professional when it comes to artwork. Some of you guys also do a good job when it also comes to artwork. So you guys at home, all you have to do is just get your material. Let your parent, let your guardian purchase some art project for you guys. And you guys could start your own art. Google your own art, and you guys can do a good job and do your artwork. Right, Leslie?
Yeah.
Shanice is painting that bubble wrap with red. You know that pineapple is yellow, but this is just a simple art project we're doing, guys, so we can choose any color that you would like. So we choose red. Right, Shanice?
Yes, yeah.
Right. Choose the color of red. Shanice finished painting the bubble wrap. This is what it looks like, guys. That's what the bubble wrap.
wrap look like. And now we're going to put the construction paper, the bubble wrap, and top of the construction paper. Okay, Leslie?
Okay.
And Leslie's going to hold it down on the paper. Hold it down with both hands, Leslie. We're going to get the paint on the paper, okay? We're going to get the paint. Come on, Leslie. Are you holding it down, Leslie?
Yeah.
You sure? All right. Okay, Leslie, take it off. Take off the bubble wrap. All right. Good job, Leslie. Hold up the bubble wrap, the paper, Leslie, so they can see what it looks like. Hold it up. So, guys, this is what the bubble wrap paint do to the construction paper. Then we're going to cut it out. Okay, we're going to cut it out next. Shalise's going to be cutting it out. Hold the paper. I'll show you something real quick. Okay. Cut out that circle, Shanice. Go ahead, Shanice. Cut out that circle. Show them, Leslie. Show them after they cut it out, look what it looks like.
I like it.
Do you like it, Leslie?
Yeah.
Then Leslie, we're gonna glue this on the paper. Let me hold this, Leslie. I'm going to put the glue on the paper, Leslie. The paper that you cut out, I'm going to put the glue on it. And Leslie, you're going to put this, turn it over like this. Hold it down, Leslie. Hold it down. And we're going to glue this part also, leaves. gonna put it right here. Hold down the leash, Leslie. Show this to them, Leslie. Oh, a pineapple art project. You guys like it?
Yeah.
You like it, Leslie? That's our pineapple art project look like, guys. I hope you guys enjoy watching the videos. I hope you guys are staying safe out there. Goodbye. We love you and we miss you. Goodbye.
Bye.
Marianne and Rosita.
Yes.
We are here just to do simple coloring. Okay?
Yes.
And what are you going to color?
Watermelon.
Watermelon. Why are you coloring watermelon, Marianne?
Because it's summertime.
It's summertime, and in the summertime we get a lot of watermelon, right?
Yes.
You're driving by the roadside and you see watermelon for sale.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
So you're going to show your coloring skill,
yes.
Marianne.
Yes.
We have four brushes here, small brushes, and Marianne is going to be, this is an example of the watermelon. That we're going to have Marianne to do one and Rosita do one. So Marianne, you start with the green. I'll hold it for you. Okay, start with the green. And we're going to color this right here in green. Okay, can I give you a little help with that?
Yeah.
Okay, you're going to color it in green. Try to keep in the line. Try to keep the line. Very good. Go around. Need more color. Don't be afraid to use up the color. Okay?
Yes.
All the way around.
Yes.
All the way around. All the way around. Okay? Again. Keeping the line. Keeping the line. Marianne is doing her own coloring skill.
Yes.
I do not want to do it. Marianne is doing it all. Just a little assistant by holding her hand. Yes. This is what it's all about.
Yes.
A little assistance right there.
Yes.
Keeping the line.
Yes.
Keeping the line.
Yes.
And it's not going to be, you don't have to be perfect.
Yes.
The important thing is that she's using her hands to keep within the line. Okay,
yes.
Maybe she go with the line. That's fine. That's fine if you go with the line. No big thing.
No.
Keep it up. Go on. Some more. Go on. Go around. Okay. It's okay. It's okay to make a mistake. It's all right.
Yes.
It's okay.
Yes.
That's you doing it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There you are.
Yes.
There you are. There you are.
Yes.
Well, that's... See?
Yes.
Okay. Very good, Marianne. Maybe I could take the brush a little bit, Marianne, and just dab it in there a little bit.
Yes.
See? Right around there.
Yes.
Just to give you a little helping hand. Okay? Is that fine?
Fine.
Okay. Now, are you going on to another color, Marianne?
Mm-hmm.
Black.
Black.
You can take the brush here and you can dip it in here. Go ahead. Dip it in. Dip it in.
Yes.
Got it? Dip it in some more.
Uh-huh.
Okay, let's see what happens. And you're going to color these. These are the seed, the melon seed.
Yes.
Black.
Black.
I think we need more black. Don't be afraid to dip it in. Let me help
black.
You. Let me help you.
Yes.
This is a lot of accomplishment for Marianne. Okay? Color the seed in black. Black? Okay, another seed. Black. Black, black, and black. Very good.
Yes.
Now, what other color do we need, Marianne? We need red.
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 Okay, so if you brush in the red, if you brush in the red,
yes.
Red, 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 paint, red, and you're going to color between all these places, okay? All these places. All around. All around. All around. All these faces are going to fill in with red, see?
Yes.
Red, 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 red. Okay? Okay. Okay, Mariana. So, Mariana, you want to show your painting? Which one did you do, Mariana? Show it. Hold it. This one, right?
This one.
Great job, Mariana. Good. Rosita. Okay, so we did Mariana. And now Rosita is going to do a small slice of watermelon. Right, Rosita? Yes. Tell them what you're going to do, Rosita. You're going to color?
Color.
Watermelon. Okay?
Yeah.
So first, Rosita is going to start with green. I put the brushes here. Here, Rosita. You're going to dip it in the green. This is the green. Right, Rosita? And Rosita is going to color outside the watermelon in green. More. More, 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 more. Steady, steady, steady. Here we are in green. That's for Rosita. Watermelon is green. Now, Rosita, you need a red. Show me red, Rosita. Show me the color red. Come on. Touch the color red. That's white. Red is this one, right? Hold your brush, Rosita. Hold it. And you're going to dip it in. And you're going to be red. Come on, let's go. Color the red. Color the red, Rosita. Color the red. Color the red, Rosita. Okay, you're doing fine. You're doing fine, Rosita. Fine. Rosita is doing a little motor skill right here, which is great, okay? I'm just guiding her a little bit. A little bit of help, right, Rosita? Wow, look at that. Look at that, Rosita. Now you need a black. Rosita is going to color a little seed black. The melon seed. Hold it, Rosita. Hold your brush. Hold your brush. Hold your brush. Hold your brush. Good job. You hold it right? Okay, so now you're going to be coloring black seed. Let's go. There you are. A little bit of black. Fill your space up. Black. Well, yeah. Turn the brush around if you want to. That's it. Black. Wow, look at that. Show it off, Rosita. Here, hold it up, Rosita. Show your watermelon off. That's Rosita coloring skill. Do you like it, Rosita?
Yeah.
Good job, Rosita. So we all get a chance to do our own little motor skill, right?
Yeah.
Right, Marietta?
Yeah.
Good. Thank you guys for watching. Say thank you, Rosita.
Thank you, Rosita.
Say hi guys at home.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Hi everyone, I hope everyone is doing safe. I'm here with Andy.
Hi.
Okay, so we're going to do today another experiment. I call it that because I never done ice cream before. And I'm going to do ice cream in a mason jar. Okay, this is like a 16-ounce mason jar, maybe a little bigger. So you need a mason jar. You need heavy whipped cream. No, I'm sorry, not heavy whipped cream. Heavy whipping cream. Okay? You need a measuring cup, you need some salt, and you need some vanilla. I brought some vanilla from home right here. You need a half a teaspoon. Okay, this only makes one serving, okay? And it's gonna take a little while
for it to set because it's ice cream, it needs to go to the freezer. So the first thing we need, Angie, is to pour. This is 1 cup, this is 8 ounces. Can you pour the cream in here? Nice and easy. Okay, you can stop. Okay, good. Now, can you put the cream in here now? No, the one you pour. Nice and easy in there, okay?
Yes.
There you go. Okay, good. This is 1/2 teaspoon. 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. I'm just gonna put that there, okay?
Yes.
And then the recipe says a pinch of salt. So just enough because sweetness needs a little bit of salt. Just a pinch of salt. That went kind of a lot, but anyway, now we're gonna close it. And Angie, she has to shake it for at least 3 or 4 minutes, which we're not gonna be. She has to shake, and we'll see you in 3 hours because we have to put her in the freezer for at least 3 hours. So we'll show you the results in 3 hours, all right? Okay, guys, it's been 3 hours, a little over 3 hours, and we're gonna get the ice cream out, okay? So Angie, hey, this is the end. See? Okay, go ahead. Okay, there you go. Let me see. Wow. I think you needed a little more time in the freezer, but it's ice cream. Oops. Mira?
Yes?
Homemade ice cream. Put it apart. Without a machine in a jar. Alright? Thank you guys.
Bye!
Hello everyone. Hope everyone is doing fine and healthy and your family. Okay? We miss you guys. Can't wait till all of us get back together again, right? But for the time being, let's just enjoy the videos and Zoom, right? And continue to pray for one another, okay? All right, today Miss Agnes wants to do some Spanish. Can you do some Spanish with me, guys? Now, the Spanish-speaking family, we know that you know a lot of the basic words, but we want to help the ones that do not speak Spanish and would love to do some Spanish words. Okay, guys? But you guys at home that speak Spanish can write sentences. Can you write your own Spanish word, translate them in English, write sentences with them, right? Continue practicing, right? So, guys, let's go over some words. And you help me, please, repeat the words, right? Okay, the first one we're going to do is dedo, dedo, and dedo is a finger, right? Finger, dedo. The next one is ojos, ojos. What is that? You're right, eyes, ojos is your eyes. Nariz, what is nariz? Nariz is your nose, nariz. Cuerpo, cuerpo is your body, right? Body, cuerpo. Very good. Orejas, orejas is your ears. Right, guys? Cara, cara is your face. Got a face. Mano. Mano. It's what? Your hand, right? Okay, guys. I expect you to do some sentences with these words. Pelo. Pelo is hair. Hair. You guys are doing great. Boca. Boca is mouth. Boca, mouth. Cabeza. Cabeza. Cabeza is your head, right? Guys, you did great, okay? Again, like I said, the Spanish-speaking family, you can write sentences. Write your own Spanish words. Translate them in English. Okay, that's good practice at home, or do reading in Spanish, right? Okay, one more time. Let's go over. Cabeza, cabeza is head. Boca, boca is what? Mouth. Pelo, pelo is hair. Very good. Mano. Mano is correct. Your hand. Cara. Cara is your face. Very good. Oreja. Oreja is your ears. Cuerpo. Cuerpo is your body. Nariz is your nose. Very good. Ojos is your eyes. Good, guys. And the last one is dedo. Dedo, finger. Finger. Very good, guys. Well, those are the basic Spanish words, right? And there will be many more lessons with more words and numbers and alphabets and colors, right? But now I want you to join me for a song, okay? And the tune of the song is, Are You Sleeping? Are You Sleeping? It's going to be that tune, but I'm going to say the Spanish word and then translate it in English. Can you join me in this song? Of course you can, right? Miss Agnes loves to have fun, right? So let's have some fun. And guess what? I have my granddaughter, Janelle, who's going to join me to sing this song.
Hola!
Okay, so are we ready to sing this song together? Okay. One, two, and three. Padre es father, madre es mother, chico boy, chica girl, abuelo is grandpa, abuela is grandma, our familia, our family. All right, guys, come on, one more time, sing it with Miss Agnes. You ready? Padre, father, madre, mother, chico boy, chica girl, abuela is grandpa, abuela is grandma, our familia, our family. Very good. Thank you, Janelle, for joining
Adios.
Me. Well, guys, I enjoyed this little Spanish lesson. There will be more and more singing because Miss Agnes loves to sing and you guys love to sing with me, right? Okay. All right, guys. Well, again, stay safe. Keep the prayers going, right? And don't worry. Everything will be fine. We'll be back together again, okay? So, stay strong. And I will see you soon. Love you. God bless.